ladies and gentlemen, Julie Andrews.
It fills all my needs to be where there is music. I'd follow the piper wherever he leads to be. Play a scale and that's it. I blow all my cool, I do. Why, I don't have a clue. But bring on the trumpets, the strings and the reeds. Where there is music, I'll be there. I climb every mountain and ford every stream. Bass drum and join any team to be where there is music. I feel joy unrestrained, ingrained in my heart, and it can't be contained. I must be a part of it, some little part of it.
Gentlemen, it's lovely to be here and grand to be back on a stage once again. Oh boy, I'm lucky. I'll say I'm lucky. This is my lucky day. Shout hooray! I found a horseshoe, couldn't go wrong. And then, of course, you happened along. Oh boy, I'm lucky. Yeah. I'm lucky. This is my lucky day. I'm lucky. This is my lucky day. This is my lucky I'm lucky to have this wonderful orchestra behind me. I'm lucky to have so many lovely people in my life. I'd like to share with you some of the people and the places and the music that have been important to me along the way. Oscar Hammerstein wrote in The Sound of Music, he said, "Let's start at the very beginning, a very good place to start." Well, my beginning was in Walton-on-Thames, Surrey, England. That's about 20 miles south of London. I've always been very proud of my British heritage. You know, the lovely green countryside and roses in every garden, jolly pubs along the river, friendly policemen. Noel Coward wrote about it. "London pride has been handed down to us. London pride is a flower that's free. London pride means our own dear town to us, and our pride it forever will be. Hey lady, when the day is dawning, see the policeman yawning on his lonely beat. Gay lady, Mayfair in the morning, hear the footsteps echo in the empty street. Cockney feet mark the beat of history. Every street pins a memory down. Nothing ever can break or harm the charm of London town." London pride actually is a flower. It's a little pink flower, and it grows in almost every English garden. This song was written in 1941 during the Blitz. I was a child then, growing up in what I considered to be a normal environment, the world of music hall, vaudeville, show business. My mom and my stepdad were entertainers, and I traveled with them all over the countryside. I guess you could say my mom was a bit of a stage mom. Oh, she wasn't terrible. She was warm and loving and very strict with us kids. But every once in a while, she would leap into action on my behalf and harass some poor theater manager, provoking the kind of response that was written about so wittily by Noel Coward in this song. "Don't put your daughter on the stage, Mrs. Worthington. Don't put your daughter on the stage. The profession is overcrowded and the struggle's pretty tough. And admitting the fact she's burning to act, well, it isn't quite enough. It's a loud voice, and though it's not exactly flat, she'll need a little more than that to earn a living wage. On my knees, Mrs. Worthington, please, Mrs. Worthington, don't put your daughter on the stage." Mom and Dad had a double act. He was a tenor. In fact, he taught me to sing when I was a child. And Mum was a fine pianist, and she accompanied him at the piano. But as she often said, it never hurts to add a little something to the act. And so every once in a while, they'd bring me out on stage, and I'd stand on a box in order to reach the microphone, and I'd belt out a couple of songs. I had a really freak voice when I was a child. It was four octaves long, extremely high and thin and squeaky. Well, I'll play you a bit of an actual recording I made when I was 12 years old. Listen.
Ladies and gentlemen, Julie Andrews. Well, Julie, is this the first time you've ever made a gramophone record?
Oh, yes. Is it your first record, too?
No, not exactly, no. How old are you?
I am 12. How old are you?
I think I'd better ask the questions. What are you going to sing for us?
I'd like to sing the Polonaise from Nîmes.
Oh, lovely.
Of success. No comment. She has nice hands to give the wretched girl her due, but don't you think her bust is too developed for her age? Now, my voice might have been a freak of nature, but nature did not stop there. She also gave me spindly legs and teeth with large spaces in between, and what they called a lazy eye, which in my case wasn't lazy at all. It led a very active life, wandering off on its own whenever it felt like it. Then, to top it off, this dear child with the pigtails and the patent leather Mary Janes, this child went and developed a bosom. This was a predicament. I mean, I was supposed to look very young. That was my gimmick in those days. But I was very proud of my new blossoming figure, and I had no wish to hide it. To overcome my objections, my parents hit upon an idea that could only have been born of desperation. It was wartime, and they assured me that if I strapped down my bust, it would help to win the war. Well, they said that about everything in those days. And I guess it did help, because we did win, didn't we? She's a big girl, and though her diction's fairly good, she's not the type I ever would be eager to engage. She's a ham, Mrs. Worthington. Oh, damn, Mrs. Worthington. I'm not saying absolutely there's no place for her, of course. At a pinch, I'm sure that she could play the rear end of a horse. I'm convinced she'd make her mark with some incredible disguises. And she'd do just fine as one who's killed before the curtain rises. But for the sake of Shakespeare, Ibsen, Shaw, Dick Rogers and Cole Porter, don't put your daughter, you really shouldn't oughta, don't put your daughter on the stage. They did put me on the stage, and I loved performing. I loved all the attention that I got. But better than that was the education I received. I mean, every night if I wanted to, I could stand in the wings and watch all those fabulous music hall acts do their stuff. I saw singers and dancers and comedians and acrobats and jugglers and magicians and quick change artists and animal acts and male and female impersonators and on and on. There was a lady that I loved to watch when I was young. She was a tiny woman about this high. She had beautiful, fine bones. Her name was Ella Shields. And in real English music hall tradition, she would dress up as an elegant bum, and she would perform this music hall classic, Maestro. Maestro. Bert. Perhaps you've heard of me, Bert. You've had word of me jogging along, hearty and strong, living on plates of fresh air. I dress up in fashion, and when I am feeling depressed, I shave from my cuff all the whiskers and fluff, stick my hat on and toddle up west. I'm a Burlington Bertie. I rise at 10:30 and saunter along like a toff. I walk down the Strand with my gloves on my hand, and then I walk down again with them off. Rothschilds, I swank it, my body I plank it on his front doorstep with the Times for a blanket. I'm Bert, Bert, and Rothschild was hurt. He said, you can't sleep there. I said, oh? He said, I'm Rothschild, sonny. I said, that's damn funny. I'm Burlington Bertie from Bow. And I rise at 10:30, then Buckingham Palace I view. I stand in the yard while they're changing the guard, and the king shouts across, toodaloo! The Prince of Wales' brother, along with, oh, some other, slaps me on the back and says, come and see mother, I'm Bert, Bert, and royalty's hurt. When they ask me to dine, I say, just had a banana with Lady Diana. I'm Burlington Bertie. I'm Burlington Bertie. I'm Burlington Bertie. I'm Burlington Bertie from at the time how all that long spell in vaudeville would help me later in my career. And it wasn't until I made that long journey to Broadway a few years later that I realized how lucky I was to have some of that experience behind me. Woe, Liza, see the cost of marrows, vegetable marrows, and the fruit piled high. Woe, Garden Market, where the costers cry. All I want is a room somewhere, far away from the cold night air, with one enormous chair. Wouldn't it be lovely? Lots of chocolate for me to eat. Lots of coal making lots of heat. Warm face, warm hands, warm feet. Oh, wouldn't it be lovely? Oh, so lovely, sitting abso-bloomin-ludely still. I would never budge till spring crept over me windowsill. One's head resting on my knee, warm and tender as he can be, who takes good care of me. How wouldn't it be lovely, lovely? This song brings back a lot of memories. When I was in rehearsal for My Fair Lady, I was just awful as Eliza Doolittle. I couldn't get the hang of the role at all, and I worked long hours with our wonderful director, Moss Hart. He went home to his wife, Kitty Carlisle, one day, and Kitty said to him, "Well, how is she? How's Julie doing?" And he said, "Oh, I don't know. I don't know." He said, "You know, if this were the good old days, I'd take the honeymoon suite in the Plaza Hotel. I'd take Julie up there for the weekend, and we'd make passionate love to each other, and she'd emerge Monday morning a star." And years later, Kitty told me that she said to Moss, she said, "Well, darling, we know we love each other. If you really think it'll do some good, go ahead, be my guest." The honeymoon suite at the Plaza Hotel is absolutely beautiful. I'm told. Oh, so lovely, sitting absolutely still. I would never budge till spring crept over me windowsill. Someone's head resting on my knee, warm and tender as he can be. Takes good care of me, how wouldn't it be lovely, 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 lovely. I first came to America when I was 18 years old to do a show on Broadway called The Boyfriend. God, I was so scared and nervous. I had no idea what I was doing. And I remember on the first day of rehearsals, I looked out of my hotel window and I noticed that it was raining. And I thought, oh, great, that's going to make me feel a bit more like home. So I got dressed and I went down into the street, and it really was with rain, and it was kind of windy and odd, and well, I walked about 10 paces and my umbrella was just pulled inside out in my hand, and I walked a little bit further and it was just yanked out of my hand and flew off somewhere. Well, I made the block and a half to rehearsals all right, and I staggered in through the stage door, and I said to the old doorman that was sitting there, I said, "Hello, hello, I'm Julie Andrews and I'm here for rehearsals, and boy, it's raining out there and it's so windy, and where is everybody?" And he said, "Well, everybody stayed home, dear. That's Hurricane Hazel out there." I had no idea. Well, in Hartford, Hereford, and Hampshire, hurricanes hardly ever happen. He was very dear, very wise. He said, "You must love the theater an awful lot to come out on a terrible day like this." And he was right. I was in love. High as a mountain, deep as a river. Come rain or come shine. I guess when you met me, it was just one of those things. But don't ever bet me, 'cause I'm gonna be true if you'll let me. You're gonna love me like nobody's loved me. Come rain or come shine, happy together, unhappy together, won't it be fine? Days may be cloudy or sunny, we're in or we're out of the money, but I'm with you all. I love that song. One of the nice things about doing a concert evening is that I get a chance to sing some of the songs that I normally don't have a chance to sing, some of my favorites, and that's one of them. And that lovely arrangement was done by our own Bob Florence, who's sitting right here at the piano. You know, we've been doing quite an extensive concert tour, and it's done wonders for my ego being out on the road. We were in Cincinnati, and I was coming to the theater one day for rehearsals, and I was in the lobby of our hotel, and an old lady recognized me. She was adorable, but she went a little bit crazy. She said, oh, Julie Andrews! Julie Andrews, right? Oh, I've seen The Sound of Music 15 times. And I said, really, 15 times? And she said, oh, yes, I never miss a good Christopher Plummer movie. Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, it's then I remember my favorite things. I simply remember my favorite things. Even though the sound of it is really quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilistic. Supercalifragilistic. Expialidocious. But the fact is, everything today is thoroughly modern. Check your personality. Everything today makes yesterday slow. Better face reality. Men say it's criminal what women will do. What they're forgetting is this is 1922. Have you seen the way they kiss in the movies? Isn't it delectable? Painting lips and pencil lining your brow. Now is quite respectable. Goodbye, good goody girl. I'm changing and how? So beat the drums, 'cause here she comes. Beat the drums, 'cause here comes thoroughly modern Minnie now. If the boy is kissable, now it's quite permissible. Goodbye, good goody girl. I'm changing and how? So beat the drums. Here she comes! Beat the drums, 'cause here comes thoroughly modern Millie. Now! Crazy world, full of crazy contradictions, like a child. First you drive me wild, and then you win my heart with your wicked art. 1 minute tender, gentle, then temperamental as a summer storm. Just when I believe your heart's getting warmer, you're cold and you're cruel, And I, like a fool, try to cope. The same old roller coaster ride, but I've got my pride. I won't give in, even though I know I'll never win. Oh, how I jazz hot, baby, and don't ever let it end. I tell your friend it's really something to hear. I can't sit still when there's that rhythm near me. Also, baby, the jazz hot, baby, what's holding my soul together? You know what jazz has such rad. clear day. Rise and look around you, and you'll see who you are. On a clear day, how it will astound you that the glow I sang and I spoke the words of a gentle, gifted man, a brilliant and sensitive writer who had that rare gift of combining wit with a real understanding of human feelings. Here, along with the music of Burton Lane and Frederick Lowe, here are some of the words of Alan J. Lerner. Maybe the sun gave me the power, for I could swim Loch Lomond and be home in half an hour. Maybe the air gave me the drive, for I'm all aglow and alive. What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Yes, it's almost like being in love. All the music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. What did I have that I don't have? What did he like that I lost track of? What did I do that I don't do the way I did before? What isn't there that once was there? What have I got a great big lack of? Wouldn't I be the late great me if I knew how? What did I have I don't have now? Where am I going? I ain't certain. All I know is I am on my way. When will I be there? I don't know. When will I get there? I ain't certain. All I know is I am on my way. Got a dream, boy. Got a song. Well, paint your how to handle a woman. There's a way, said the wise old man, a way known by every woman since the whole rigmarole began. Do I flatter her? He begged him answer. Do I threaten or cajole or plead? Do I brood or play the gay romancer? Said he smiling, no indeed. How to handle a woman? Mark me well, I will tell you, sir. Each evening from December to December, before you drift to sleep upon your cot, think back on all the tales that you remember of Camelot. Ask every person if he's heard the story, and tell it strong and clear if he has not, that once there was a fleeting wisp of glory called Camelot. Camelot. Above. If you're in love, show me. Tell me no dreams filled with desire. If you're on fire, show me. Here we are together in the middle of the night. Don't talk of spring, just hold me tight. Anyone who's ever been in love will tell you that. This is no time for a chat. Haven't your lips longed for my touch? Well, don't say how much. Show me. Show me, don't wait until wrinkles and lines pop out all over my brow. Show me now. I could have danced all night. I could have danced all night. have begged for more. I could have spread my wings and done a thousand things I've never done before. I'll never know what made it so. goodbye. Why, I can barely say goodnight. If I can hardly take my eyes from yours, how far can I go? Walk away, the thought would never cross my mind. I couldn't turn my back on spring. Your smile, least of all, when I say always, I mean forever. I trust tomorrow as much as today. Soon, I hope. Thank you. Good night.